Okay, fine, I'll do it. I'll show you how to set up your very own secure browser. The world's most secure. Seriously, it's amazing. But full disclosure, I actually launched this product 2 weeks ago. The Networkchuck Cloud Browser is the world's most secure browser, in my opinion. But I got a little bit of hate from that video. Not a lot of hate, but some. Yes, I know it's Kasm. I partnered with them. I think they kind of know about it because they're hosting it. And yes, I know you can host it yourself for free, and that's why I'm making this video. Because if you're not gonna use the Networkchuck Cloud Browser, I at least want you to set this up yourself. So yeah, I'm gonna show you how to set up the product I'm selling for free, which doesn't make any sense. I know, it sounds kind of stupid. Like, Chuck, are you gonna lose money on this video? Maybe. No, but seriously, what I really care about is that you and your family and your friends and whoever you know is safe when they're browsing online. It's a wild place out there. And whether you use my browser or your own, I want you to use this technology. It's amazing. I don't care how you get it. So quick coffee break. And let's get started. Now, setting this up is actually pretty cool and pretty quick. Then afterwards, I do want to address some of the kind of hate I got, really just concerns around me launching my product, the Networkchuck Cloud Browser. But anyways, I want to get you set up self-hosted so you can play with this. Now, I also want to address some of the concerns from the community about my new browser, mainly around security, which we'll touch on that. Now, if you did not watch the video where I demoed my new browser, go watch it. It'll explain how this thing works. And also, I scared my girls with viruses in the process, so at least go watch that. The things I do to keep you guys safe. But TLDR, the Networkchuck Cloud Browser, is essentially run on Kasm workspaces. And what we're talking about here is a web browser launched inside of a Docker container and then streamed to your browser. That just sounds like magic, right? And when you're done, you just delete the browser, you delete the Docker container, it's all gone. That's part of what makes it really secure. Now, this whole Kasm thing is actually free. You can install and host it anywhere. And I'm gonna show you how to put it in the cloud. Specifically, our sponsor, Lenode, cloud computing by Akamai. But seriously, Lenode is awesome. I use them all the time for everything. And they work perfectly with Kasm. So go ahead and check the link in the description. If you click that link and you're new to Lenode, you'll get $100 credit for how many days? Oh, 60 days. So testing out Kasm right now will be free for you if you're new. So try it out. So once you're logged into Lenode, go ahead and click on Create and Lenode. Dude, I stinking love Lenode. We'll choose our image. I'm gonna go with Ubuntu 22.04. Region, somewhere close to me. I'm in Dallas. And then our Lenode plan. I'm gonna click on Shared CPU. Now, one thing I love about Lenode real quick is that you can get a Linux server in the cloud for $5 a month, which I do all the time. So if you have another project in mind, this one's pretty cool. But for our project with Kasm, we need the Lenode 4 GB. So we'll click that, $20 a month. Now, just so you know, you're not paying $20 right now, or $5 right now, whatever plan you go with. You're charged by the hour, so you spin this up, play with it for like 1 hour, 2 hours, delete it. It's gonna cost you, what, 3 cents an hour? So anyways, let's continue. I'll name it Not Networkchuck Cloud Browser, and put a password in. That's all we have to do. I'm gonna click on Create, and take a little coffee break while it brews up. It'll take just a few moments. If you want to monitor while you wait, you can click on the Launch Lish console at the top right, and you can feel like you're in the Matrix. Oh yeah, there it goes. Now you could log in here, I don't like that. I like using my terminal, so I'm gonna grab the SSH access information over here. Just gonna copy that, fire up my terminal. It'll also be terminal in Mac and Linux, and paste that command in there. Yes to accept all fingerprints, and then put in your password. We're in. Now before we install, we gotta update our stuff, our repositories. So we'll do a sudo apt update. This should be fairly quick, give us some time. And then we're gonna grab this command, and I'll have this below, by the way. We're gonna paste this in just like this, and literally that's all we have to do. Kasm takes it from there, they do everything else. That's gonna take a minute, so go ahead and hit enter, and it's gonna do its thing for a while. So do take a coffee break right now. And kind of just, I don't know, meditate, watch the screen. It's kind of nice. It also feels really cool, like you're actually doing something when you're not. Like, look at this. I feel awesome and I'm doing nothing. Okay, mine is done. That took a little bit, right? But here we are. And here's how you access your stuff. I'll go to Lenode, I'll click on Network, the little network tab right there. And then what we want is right over here, reverse DNS. Just grab that address right there, copy it, go up to your address bar, type in https://, and off to the races. Go ahead and continue, proceed, and here we are. Now your login info was in the command line in your terminal. If you scroll up just a little bit, you'll see Kasm UI login credentials. They'll have one for a user and one for the admin. We'll probably want the admin right now. I'll grab the password, memorizing that super complicated username, admin@kasm.local, and paste in the password, login. Now, I'm not gonna cover the ins and outs of Kasm. I have a previous video on that. What you care about is a secure browser. Right now, we're on the admin. We want workspaces. So click on workspaces, and we're here. Pick your browser, whatever you want. Let's click Brave, launch session. At this very moment, a Docker container is being spun up, a browser is being launched, and it's here. And I can safely browse things. And when I'm done, I can delete it. Now, just like the Networkchuck cloud browser, the Kasm self-hosted option does have a Chrome extension. If I go to the Chrome Web Store, search Kasm, you'll see both of them right there. Kasm is the one you want if you're self-hosting. You can install this, and once you have it installed, you'll want to peek at your extensions, click on More Actions, and click on Options to make a few changes here. Right here, the Kasm URL is something you want to change. You'll want to change it to the URL of your server. I'm going to grab that from the top right here, paste that here, and save. And then one more thing here in Kasm, I'll edit my profile. I'll go to the top right, click on my little icon, click on Edit Profile, click on Settings, and choose my default workspace image, the one that will launch when I use my little plugin. I'll say Brave. Done. So now I can open any link by right-clicking it and saying Open Link in Kasm, and that will open up inside my self-hosted secure browser. So that's how you self-host Kasm in Linode, and it's pretty awesome. But it does end up kind of costing you more money. You do have to support it yourself. And for most of us, that's totally cool. Like, that's awesome. But if you want something that's a bit more cost-effective potentially, has better performance, and you don't have to support, that's where the Networkchuck cloud browser might come in. And also, if you don't want to have to deploy all this, go ahead, tell your grandma to deploy this. I don't know, she might be really into IT. Tell her to subscribe to me.
Grandma, go subscribe to Networkchuck.
What are you doing?
Whether or not you self-host Kasm or you go with the Networkchuck cloud browser comes down to cost and convenience, like most things in life. Let's start with cost. So like right now, this whole self-hosting thing, that's not free. Yes, Kasm is free, the software. But where you put it, that place is not gonna be free. Hardware, internet, storage, it's gotta come from somewhere. Sure, you might put it on-prem in your home lab, but you gotta already have the hardware. And yeah, you could put it in the cloud, but the cloud's not free. For example, Kasm here, the minimum system requirements are 2 cores, 4 gigs of RAM, and 50 gigabytes of storage, SSD, ideally. So at minimum, you're looking at the Linode 4 gigabyte plan, which is $20 a month. Now you could go for a lower plan, I haven't experimented with that, but Kasm said you'll want this at least. And of course, cost varies depending on where you go and what you have on-prem. And if you want to self-host, if you want to try this out right now, I encourage you to do that. It's really cool and fun. But also, if you want to try out the Networkchuck cloud browser for $7 a month, that's pretty cool too. That's all I'm saying. I'm not trying to rob you guys. It's just that hosting does cost money. And then I'll touch on this real quick. The other side of this is convenience. Self-hosting, while it's really fun, is not convenient. It's not. You do have to have some IT skills, which I'll walk you through here in a moment to set this up. And let's face it, not everyone can do that. Your average person isn't necessarily a nerd like us. So think employees at a company or your family, your friends, who of course want to be protected but don't have the skills or the interest to do something like this. So yeah, you watching this video could set this up no problem. I'll show you how. It's amazing. You're gonna love it. But not everyone wants to do that or support it. You have to make sure it's up all the time. You have to make sure it's accessible. Like if it's in your home lab, how do people get to it from the outside? That's a whole thing. Not hard, but it's a thing. But if you go with a Networkchuck solution, my solution, you get support. It's convenient. You get the whole thing. All you gotta do is log in and use it, and that's nice. Especially if you want to give it to your family or your employees. Like, here, just log into this and use it. Not here, follow 20 steps to set this up. It's not 20 steps. It's gonna be like 3 minutes, but it's still a thing for people, right? I can't even get my grandma to change her password. Now, one more point on convenience. I can launch my browser for multiple locations. Europe, India, South America, USA. When you self-host it, you're restricted to one location, which might be fine for you. Now, one more thing before we set this up, and this is a pretty big concern brought up by pretty much everyone, and that's security. How secure is the Networkchuck cloud browser? Like, am I gonna track you guys and see everything you're doing? Is Kasm gonna do that? No, we're not. And shout out to IPsec who brought this up. I appreciate him sparking this discussion, it's important. So security, which, by the way, here is the Networkchuck cloud browser. You can try out a free demo right now if you wanna know what I'm talking about. Are we tracking you? No. When you launch that browser inside that container, whatever happens in that container, we don't see it. We don't log it. We don't log your activity, what you're doing, anything. And when you're done, it's gone. And no, we don't keylog, we don't screen record, track websites, or collect any kind of telemetry data. Nothing. Your browsing activity, we have nothing to do with that. But when it comes to user logins, requests for sessions, like you want to request a Docker container to be built up, we do track that kind of application level data. And it's mainly for performance and stability, just to make sure things are working well. But it's also for meeting requirements as a cloud-based service provider on another cloud service. And in this case, it's gonna be AWS and OCI. Now, I'm sure for many of you, you're like, can anything I do be traced back to me? And that's a good question. Let me show you this. Let's say there's 5 users who have launched a browser and a container. And our solution, there's a bunch of servers being load balanced and all kinds of stuff to make this application work. So the odds are, that multiple users could be sharing the same IP address. And let's say one of you, I'm not saying who, there's nobody, I don't have anybody, one of you used the Networkchuck cloud browser to access something illegal. We wouldn't know about it because we don't track what's going on inside your browser session. Now sure, this illegal activity may be flagged by a service provider like OCI or AWS, and they'll say, hey, who accessed this illegal thing? We'll say, you know, we're not sure because this IP address at that time was used by all these people and we don't know who did it. So even if law enforcement did ask us for logs, which we would give them because that's the law, it would be difficult to trace back to any one person. Now don't get me wrong, when I'm saying this, I'm not saying, yeah, come use the Networkchuck Cloud browser for illegal activity. I'm not saying that. In fact, this system is not built for that. And while Kasm has been operating as a SaaS for 4 years now and has had no incidents with law enforcement, we're not advertising the service as a means for illegal activity. If you want to do something illegal, this is not the product for you. We cannot guarantee that you can use our product and do illegal things with impunity or to not get caught. But when it comes to security, anonymity, and privacy, we have your back. Now, if you're like, Networkchuck Cloud browser, it's not safe, I can't do my illegal stuff. You know, that problem doesn't go away whether you self-host or not. If you're self-hosting, you still have your ISP to deal with, wherever you're hosting it at. The internet traffic's going to exit somewhere and be seen by someone. And if it's being tracked by law enforcement as illegal activity, that can be tied back to you. So before we move on, let me just make sure I covered all your concerns. And actually, this guy posted a whole thing. He said, you gotta respond to this. And I'm like, okay. Person can watch everything. We don't. Busted. Tor or Tails does the same thing, but are free and open source. So is Kasm. And Kasm has Tor. But I would say the Networkchuck Cloud browser and Kasm does a much better job at keeping you anonymous and keeping your stuff private. It's not just a VM, it's a Docker container. You could do the same kind of thing with VirtualBox, but it wouldn't be as secure. You'd be using your own public IP address at your house. And sure, you could be using a VPN, but then they see what you're doing. It's really all about who you trust. Because at some point on the internet, you're deciding to trust somebody. Just a modified version of Kasm run on Oracle? Yes, it is. No, I didn't invent a proxy. Yeah, it's kind of like VPN, except VPN doesn't make sure your cookies, browsing history, and everything isn't saved inside a browser. You're still being fingerprinted in your browser, even if you're using a VPN. Yes, it is safe for viruses, like my girls learned, but not for privacy. No, it's safe for privacy. And yes, US laws will be obeyed. So again, if you want to do illegal things, don't come here. Not important, not important. And we covered this. Whew, I think we're done. Yeah, I gave my kids trauma just for you. Remember that. So subscribe and like and comment and all that stuff. And this guy's right. You are putting your trust in me and Kasm. Now, I wouldn't say I'm selling out. I'm offering a solution. You don't have to take it, and I'm gonna show you how to do your own right now. But at the end of the day, on the internet, you're trusting someone. Choose wisely. Now, James Titus has a pretty cool solution. If you wanna do this, you can. But if you're reading this, it sounds kinda complex. Like, your average person will not do this. Even most engineers and researchers don't wanna bother with this. They want something that will work all the time. Again, at the end of the day, I don't care what you do, as long as you keep yourself safe. Would I love for you to use the Networkchuck Cloud browser? Yeah, and by doing that, you're also supporting what I do, and you're supporting Kasm. But anyways, that's the video. Catch you guys later.